Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This is Marston, the ZimTech guy. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. And if you do eventually end up liking the video, please hit that like button. Just a quick side note, if you enjoy the work that I do on this channel, please consider partnering with me on Patreon. For a small fee, you can help me improve the quality of videos on this channel. Making these videos actually takes a lot of time, equipment, money, and research. With your support, you can help me overcome some of those challenges. On that note, help me give a big thanks to my top Patreon, Tom Bodkin. Thank you for the support, man. I really appreciate it. Now, Kariba. The name means small trap in Shona. Well, not really Shona. The name Kariba is believed to be a corruption of the Shona word Kariba, meaning a small trap. It is believed that the Italians, who were constructing the dam wall, wanted to explain the nature of the project to the local Batonga people. They emphasized that they wanted to build a small water trap, Kariba. However, the complex pronunciation of the V in Kariba saw the Italian constructors produce a sound much like a B, hence the creation of the word Kariba. We cannot talk about Lake Kariba without first talking about the Zambezi River, whose source is in the Mwinelunga district in northwest Zambia. More specifically, the source is a marshy black wetland known as Dambo, in the center of the iconic Miombo woodlands. The Zambezi covers 1,352,000 square kilometers and spans 8 countries, namely Angola, Botswana, Malawi, Mozambique, Namibia, Tanzania, Zambia, and Zimbabwe. It flows for some 2,650 kilometers from its source to the Indian Ocean. It is the fourth largest river in Africa, flowing into the Indian Ocean at Kiliman in Mozambique. The Kariba Dam is located halfway between the source and the mouth of the Zambezi River. The idea to construct the dam was believed to have been birthed in the early 1940s by the federal government of Rhodesia and Nyasaland. Northern Rhodesia is modern-day Zambia, and Southern Rhodesia is Zimbabwe, and Nyasaland is Malawi. In the early 1940s, a report was made about the possibility of a hydroelectric scheme to supply power for the growing industry that colonialism had brought to Northern and Southern Rhodesia. The Electricity Supply Commission instigated an investigation for possible hydroelectric schemes to be situated at what now is Kariba, and in 1941, funds were allocated. Both Southern Rhodesia and Northern Rhodesia were in contention, as it was thought that the Kafue River Gorge site in Northern Rhodesia was preferable to Kariba. The matter was solved in 1951 by a board of experts known as the panel, who all agreed that the dam was to be built on the Zambezi River at the Kariba Gorge site. In August 1955, the then federal government of Rhodesia and Nyasaland called for tenders for the construction of the wall and power station, and an Italian company, Impresit, now called Salini Imprelio, won the tender and was eventually awarded the project on the 16th of July 1956. Kariba Dam was designed by a French engineer and inventor, Andre Coyne, a specialist in arch dams. He personally designed over 55 dams, Kariba being one of them. The total cost of constructing the dam was $480 million, with funds sourced from the World Bank. In September 1956, construction began, with the excavation for the foundation. In the same year, the contract to build the supporting town was given to Richard Costain. With a time limit of 2 years, the towns were built on 7 hills, namely Sugarloaf, Camp Hill, The Peak, Hospital Hill, Aerial Hill, Kariba Heights, and Boulder Ridge. Within 48 hours of the contract being signed, about 1,300 workers, including many Italians, were on site, and within 19 months, they completed shops, banks, houses, schools, meeting places, and a hospital, etc. There was also the issue that the area chosen to build the dam was home to a local tribe known as the Batonga. The local Batonga people believed that the area chosen to construct the dam wall was home to a river god known as Nyaminyami. The decision to build there would anger the god, but that did not deter the people behind the project. Construction work was going on day and night in 12-hour shifts, but the construction wasn't without its own challenges. In 1957, when the dam was well on its way to completion, Kariba experienced the worst floods ever known on the Zambezi, which washed away much of the partly built dam and heavy equipment, killing many workers. Some of those killed were Italians, whose bodies disappeared mysteriously, and after an extensive search failed to find them, Batonga elders were asked to assist as their tribesmen knew the river better than anyone. The elders explained that the Nyami Nyami River god had caused the disaster, and in order to appease his wrath, a sacrifice was to be made. Initially, they were not taken seriously, but in desperation, when relatives of the missing workers were due to arrive from Italy to claim the bodies of their loved ones, the search party agreed in the hope that the tribesmen would know where the bodies were likely to have been washed to. A black calf was slaughtered and floated on the river. The next morning, the calf was gone and the workers' bodies were in its place. The Zambezi River is home to a lot of crocodiles, but that still didn't explain the reappearance of the dead bodies. As if that wasn't enough, the next rainy season, however, brought further floods even worse than the previous year. Nyami Nyami had struck again, destroying the Koffer Dam, the access bridge, and part of the main wall. In the process, 11 Italian men were trapped in the concrete wall. It was too expensive to get them out, so to this day, their bodies remain as part of the Kariba Dam wall. All in all, a total of 86 workers died during the construction of the dam. A church, Santa Barbara Chapel, was constructed in their memory. As construction progressed, it was clear that the Batonga people would need to be relocated, something that was opposed by the villagers. They could not see a direct benefit from the construction of the Kariba Dam wall. The building of the wall and subsequent filling of the dam led to the displacement of about 57,000 people, mainly the Batonga tribe, who had been subsisting in the valley and along the river banks for centuries. However, economic advantages from the controversial development convinced the authorities that it was worth the disturbance and loss of animal life. The effect of the rising water was not only felt by the Batonga people. Soon, countless numbers of animals, birds, and insects began to feel the impact. As the waters rose, islands emerged, marking the highest points of the valley. Some were quickly covered by the rising water, and by the time the lake reached maximum level in September 1963, only the largest remained. These became the last refuge for many of the animal species living in the area. Lake Kariba has several islands, both on the Zimbabwean and Zambian side of the border. These include Maze Island, Mashape Island, Chete Island, Sekula, and Chikanka Islands, all located in Zambia. The Zimbabwean side has the following islands: Sampa Karuma, Spurwing, Starvation Island, Antelope Island, Bird Island, and Fothergill, which was named after Rupert Fothergill, a game ranger who is famously known for leading Operation Noah. As waters continued to rise, rescue work to save some of the animals that had been affected as a result of the rising water levels commenced. It was codenamed Operation Noah. Funding for this operation came in the form of aid from the government of Southern Rhodesia and an appeal via the Northern Rhodesian Game Preservation and Hunting Association to the Fauna Preservation Society in London. The appeal launched by this society provoked a flood of donations, and by the end of October 1959, 19,000 had been sent to Colonel Gritchley's Kariba Rescue Fund. Both Northern and Southern Rhodesian governments had made provision to increase expenditure on rescue operations in the new year, and more help and funds came from various societies and associations and individual people. The rescue work was extremely difficult and dangerous, with submerged trees and stumps threatening operations in the water, whilst on the islands, disoriented and defensive animals and reptiles often tried to thwart any rescue attempts. When Operation Noah ended in June 1964, an amazing total of 44 black rhino had been saved by the Southern Rhodesian team. On the Southern Rhodesian side, the number of mammals rescued was almost 5,000, while the total number of animals rescued, including birds and reptiles, was well over 6,000. While on the Northern Rhodesian side, nearly 2,000 game animals had been rescued, including deadly snakes, which were relocated to Matusadona National Park and Chete Safari Area. When construction of the Kariba Dam was complete, it was the largest wall and artificial lake in the world. But although record has since been surpassed by other dams, it's still the world's largest man-made reservoir by volume, creating a border crossing between Zimbabwe and Zambia, where people and vehicles can go from one country to another. In 1959 December, the first generator was commissioned at Kariba. In 1960, May 17th, the Kariba hydroelectric scheme was officially opened. Carpenter fish were airlifted from Lake Tanganyika in Tanzania, where they are indigenous. They bred fast and now support a large commercial fishing business in Kariba. The indigenous tiger fish have thrived on the Carpenter and further contributed to tourism in the area. There are several other species of fish in the lake. The construction of the Kariba Dam consumed over 1 million cubic meters of concrete. A statue of the river god Nyami Nyami was erected near the Kariba Dam. Nyami Nyami is depicted as a snake-like being or dragon-like creature with the snake's torso and the head of a fish. It can be found as pendants on jewelry, usually carved out of wood, stone, bone, occasionally ivory, silver, gold, or both. Elaborate traditional carved walking sticks depicting Nyami Nyami and its relationship with the valley's inhabitants were popular with tourists visiting Zambia. After the lake was completed, Matonga believed that Nyami Nyami withdrew from the world of men. Maintenance work to make the dam safe for the future is expected to be completed by 2023. In the end, economically, the Kariba Dam was a blessing for both Zimbabwe and Zambia. There you have it. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. Otherwise, see you in the next video.